always increase, enhance our immunity, and it also which helps in fighting against infection. So plus sleeping is important actually. So when a person sleep, take sound sleep or sound for sound sleep for 7 to 8 hours, then it also prevents the stress also. It also relieves a person from stress, and ultimately it also prevents the inhibition of the immunity, and ultimately also boost our immunity. So proper sleep is also very much important, which boosts our immunity at the same time makes other system working good. It also keeps our heart, normalize our blood pressure, heart also during sound sleep. We should take proper hydration and proper amount of water. So we should get regular water amount, we should take proper amount of water every day. So we should take proper hydrated substances. So hydration is very much important. So we should have proper hydrated by taking at least 8 to 10 glass of water per day. So proper, when the system is properly hydrated, then it may flush out the toxins and the virus from the body via urine, and ultimately chance of infection will decrease and it will boost our immunity. So next important point is that we should de-stress ourselves. De-stress means we should decrease our level of stress of the human body by various maneuvers or by various techniques. Stress is a biological phenomenon. It is a part and parcel of our life, especially in this season when we have to work from home, or we have to go take pressure of the work sitting at home, when there is a panicity or anxiety. So stress may be there in this pandemic season. So we should still, in spite of that, we should keep ourselves free from stress, which may, in this growing, with the growing incidence of anxiety and panicity, we should suppress our stress. And how should we make ourselves free from stress? We should increase the doing meditation. So we normally we should do meditation, but in especially in this pandemic season, or if you are stressed, then we should do regular meditation. Meditation actually brings equilibrium for the body and mind. At the same time, it will relieves you from person or its patient from a stress, and which ultimately boosts our immunity. So stress really, actually severe stress leads to secretion of a hormone known as cortisol, which suppress T cell inflammation or T cell proliferation and suppress the immunity. So when to relieve a person or to distress a person, the cortisol level should be decreased. That's why a regular practice of meditation will ultimately keep equilibrium on the body and mind, and ultimately it plays important role in distressing ourselves from any tension or anxiety. We should also avoid smoking, alcohol use and drug abuse. Smoking is also increase the chance of stress level in the body. So we should avoid smoking. Smoking kills the cilia of the pulmonary alveolar epithelium, which helps in bringing out the virus or in fact foreign particles from the inside of the pulmonary tract to outside. So in regular smoking kills the pulmonary epithelial cells and its cilia, and that's why prone the respiratory tract to infection. So if you want to prevent the subject from unnecessary RTI, respiratory infection or common cold or sore throat or viral infection like COVID-19, we should avoid smoking, because smoking is very much bad. It also gives stress on our respiratory system, pressure on the respiratory system, and all of you know, lung is the most important organ, vital organ, that is infected in COVID-19 cases. That's why we should keep our respiratory system fit by avoiding smoking. And alcohol also is good. We should avoid excessive alcohol. Also leads to kidney injury. It also also leads to change of blood pressure. At the same time, alcohol also suppresses immunity. So we have to avoid alcohol intake. So please avoid alcohol during this pandemic season, because alcohol is very much toxic to the kidney. Also is toxic to the cardiovascular system, and also it suppresses immunity. So as soon as a subject or a patient who smokes and drinks stops this smoking and drinking, the immunity will be boosted, and ultimately the virus, if infected, can be handle very nicely. At the same time, a person which is drug abuse also should be free from drug abuse or taking drugs in this season. So we should avoid smoking, avoid alcoholism and drug abuse, which will prevent you from improve your immunity. Okay. At the same time, another important thing you must do during this pandemic season is do regular exercise. Regular exercise will increase your immunity. So every day at least 30 to 45 minutes of exercise should be done, as exercise keeps the cardiovascular system fit, it also keeps the respiratory system fit, it also normalizes your blood pressure, it also helps in increase your immunity and boost your immunity, and thus it for subjects doing regular exercise will have a good improvement in its immunity, so that body's defense mechanism will be improved. So person can can handle the virus or can handle the COVID infection very nicely. Now let's come to the supplements and immunity boosting foods. So supplements are very much important actually, or those foods which boost our immunity we should give special importance. So number one is vitamin C. Vitamin C is also known as ascorbic acid. It's an important nutrition or supplements that increase our immunity or boost our immunity. It is a powerful antioxidant. Ascorbic acid is a powerful antioxidant, and it also decreases the oxidative stress. And it has been studied that many studies has found that high dose of intravenous vitamin C, if it is given, leads to decrease of complication of acute respiratory distress syndrome and septic shock. So it can be given in respiratory diseases. It also can be given in common cold, and it is an important in antioxidant and it suppresses oxidative stress. Then we can take vitamin D. So vitamin D is another important immune boosters, which is an important supplement which increase our immunity. So it helps in fighting against respiratory tract infection and also helps in boosting our immunity. So another important mineral is zinc. Then comes the zinc. So zinc deficiency leads to anosmia, viral infection, common flu and many other viral infection. So zinc deficiency may lead to viral infection, and zinc is also a T cell mediator. It increases the T cell proliferation and normalize our T cell count in the blood. So in zinc deficiency, cell immunity may be affected. So we have to take zincovit. We can take zincovit or any zinc containing substances or zinc containing supplements in this pandemic season, which can boost your immunity, as zinc is very much important in fighting viral infection, bacterial infection, common cold, flu and etc. We can take elderberries. Elderberries is a type of berries which rich in phosphorus, iron, copper, vitamin A and vitamin C. So these are very important actually. At the same time, you should not forget the role of turmeric and garlic. So turmeric is very much important or healthy. So we use normally in our diets. We can take healthy milk also, or turmeric mixed milk, or healthy doodh in this time. So healthy doodh or turmeric milk is very much important. It boosts our immunity. At the same time, garlic. Garlic is nothing but is also known as rasun. It is very much important. Garlic boosts our immunity. It is anti-cancer, anti-inflammatory, important antiseptic, and also keeps our blood pressure normal. Cardiovascular system also keeps fit, and it is also an immunity booster. Also, we should not forget to take some vegetables like carrots, spinach, sweet potato, green leafy vegetables, tomato, broccoli, and all those things. So these are very much important vegetables that we should always take. Very much important. These fruits should be taken. Citrus fruits are very much important, and like grapes, orange, lemon, they are rich in vitamin C. Vitamin C is responsible for increasing the WBC count, which is important defense line of our human body, immune system. And citrus fruits we must take. We should also take red bell peppers. Red bell peppers actually contain lots of vitamin C, and it contains beta carotene. So both vitamin C and beta carotene is very much important, and it is present in the red bell peppers, and we must take red bell peppers, or we can include in our diet. Broccoli is another important substance. It contains vitamin A, vitamin C and vitamin E. Broccoli is very rich in vitamin C, which is an anti-inflammatory agent, antioxidant, and boost our immunity or improve our immunity. Garlic contains zinc, and it also normalizes our BP, and it also anti-cancer and improve our immunity. Besides spinach, we can take spinach is a substance which is rich in vitamin C and beta carotene. We can take almonds, which is nuts. Some nuts are very much good, like almonds, cashew nuts we can take, or apricots we can take, which are rich in vitamin E. Yogurt is also good, which is full of nutrients and minerals and vitamins. So yogurt is also good, which can improve our immunity. So at this pandemic season, some immunity boosters artificially that can be taken is Chyawanprash. Chyawanprash is present normally in our diet, it may be available normally in our diet, or we can buy from the market. So Chyawanprash, 1 or 2 spoon per day in the early morning we can take, and it contains lots of minerals, vitamins and Ayurvedic preparations which boost our immunity. At the same time, we can take some special type of tea known as kara in this season. So kara should be contain water. We can include tulsi, dalchini, then black pepper, which is nothing, kali marich, then dry ginger. We can use lemon also in preparation of this kara. Kara is special type of tea we can take in this season, which will prevent us from sore throat, common cold, flu infection. At the same time, we boost our immunity and helps in fighting infections. Okay, so these are the various type of diets or various type of nutrition we should not forget to include in our diet in day-to-day practice, for which can improve our immunity. According to the Ayush, many measures are advised to be taken by the community people so as to prevent the infection of the COVID-19. So number one is drink warm water. Warm water is good. So warm water, we should take warm water. Then we can go for taking or practicing yoga regularly. Take regular amount of turmeric, coriander, cumin. We should take herbal tea containing tulsi, black pepper, ginger and ricin. At the same time, we should avoid sugary substance to prevent diabetes. And we can apply oil on your nostrils or ghee on your nostrils, and we can take inhalation of steam with mint leaves. So these are the various measures we should not forget to take, which can boost our immunity, especially supplements and good food, good nutrition, regular exercise, normal sleep, de-stressing ourselves. These are the very important factors which can prevent ourselves from exposure to the virus, and at the same time helping our immunity to fight against the virus. Okay, so we'll stop here, and all of you be safe and try to maintain these things and boost your immunity by taking these measures, and you'll be very much healthy. I know if you maintain these measures along with protective measures, I already told protective measures should be taken using mask and all those things in COVID season, which can prevent the further infection of the disease. Thank you very much.